Welcome back to What Are Teen Noobs with General Disturbance. You're looking at the Charpue 204, which is a Tier 9 French medium tank, and the T30, which is being driven by Detronix. The Charpue 204 by Fluffy Little Kitten. They're in platoon together. Well, Detronix is being left behind by Fluffy, who's got a four-shot autoloader. At least I think it's a four-shot. Yes, it is a four-shot autoloader with a 105mm gun, which is actually quite powerful. 390 alpha, penetrating 264mm of armour. But the actual tank itself has got very little armour indeed. It's got a good gun, but and a good... the reload time is actually quite long. 37.5 seconds for the reload for a clip of four, and 4 seconds between each shot. So that's a huge amount of time. And oh, Fluffy just blocked that CDC from going around that way. I think it's because the traverse angle of this tank is not that quick, and therefore he wasn't able to give enough room to the CDC. Chasseur de Chans not got a lot of armor. In fact, he just took a shot from a standard B, but Fluffy's now gonna open on this standard B, and at 390 shot he can do a lot of damage, but he is taking damage from the standard B. There's nowhere the standard B can go. He is going to take all four shots, and he's not going to get a full kill, but he goes for the ram and gets it. Smart move, go for the ram on the last few shots, but he now needs to pull back, and there's Detronix coming in. And oh, what does he do here? What are you doing, Fluffy? Don't ram into Detronix. I know you meant to do that deliberately. There was no need to do it. Bad behavior. Bad boy, Fluffy. Go and sit in the corner until your shells reload. Okay. Oh, I hope you don't do that when I'm platooning with you. The last thing you want is somebody in your own team causing problems. Anyway, he's decided to go up to the front again. He's reloaded. And he could shoot up over that ramp and help the AMX 5100. That's exactly what he's decided to do. Because he can outflank this Lurva, come down the other side, and put shells into his side. He's locked on. Yeah, first one in. And he blocked the shot with the AMX 5120, which is a smart move, actually. Let your teammate take the shots instead of you. Puts the second one in, but it didn't go through the armor. The top plate of the Lurva is actually quite strong, but he gets it through the lower plate and gets a kill. Only one shot left in his autoloader, and I think he's going to try that on the 1390 as he retreats. Yes, he gets it, but now he's reloading for 37.5 seconds, so he better find something to hide behind, and he has. Well, apart from that pile of grit, he's now hiding behind the building, and he'll have to stay here until he reloads, and that T-54 can see him. Yes, you've been spotted. Luckily, the T-44 isn't firing back in this direction yet, but he's cozying up to the side of the wall. Okay, he's almost loaded. Once he's loaded, he can go round and deal with that T-44, and he can put enough damage into him in one burst to actually put him out of the game. But the Renegade's now in the way. He's only got 22 hit points left. There's Detronix, come up behind him. Right, now go round. Oh, what are you doing here? Go round the outside. That's it, round the outside of the building. Oh, he's going the opposite way. And I think the reason was this Lanson C. Hello, Mr. Lanson. Thank you. One. Hello, Mr. Lanson. Two. Go for the three. No, pulls back before he can get the third shot in. He doesn't want to take a round from the Lanson. Not if he can help it. And the Lanson now is caught between the devil and deep blue sea. And he actually got wiped out by our Borsig. So that's good. That was good use of the shells. But he's got two shells and he needs to reload. Yep. They're doing well. Six tanks up on the enemy. But Fluffy, oh, what choices to make. I do agree with the choice about going after the Lanson C. That was a good decision. You saw that somebody was actually behind you and you decided to deal with him. You could have dealt with the T-44 though, but I think there's a Strib out in the field that's holding our guys up, and he's been dealt with. Now there's a Wizzy 111FT out there, and well, I think he wants to have a go with that one himself, but I don't think you've got a shot. The T-44 is just around the corner. Right, now let's double gang him. There you are. Hello. Remember us? He's got one in, and he's got killed by the AMX-5100. 212 in the distance. He's gone. This game's going to be all over, and it is. Where was Detronics? Oh, there he is. Let's have a look at the end of battle stats. Well, second class tanker for Fluffy Little Kitten in the Char Future 4. He managed to get a duelist for taking down two tanks that damaged him. A fire for effect for doing more damage than hit points to his own vehicle. And he got the high caliber. He dealt the most damage in that game overall. 3,799 was the win 8. Let's have a look at team score. 4,058 hit points of damage, the next high scorer being the SU-130PM on his own team with 2,558, and after that it was the T-30 on the enemy team with 2,521. When it came to kills though, it was actually shared between Fluffy, the SU-130PM, the Borsig, the Centurion, the AMX-5100 and the AMX-1390 all got two kills. Nobody on the enemy team managed to get two kills. In fact, only four of them got kills altogether. And when it came to base XP, it was actually Centurion 7-1. He got 1,025 base. 1,000 base went to Fluffy and 840 went to the Renegade. The Renegade picked up a Spartan. The Centurion 7-1 got a steel wall in that game. Fluffy fired 11 rounds in that game, got 11 direct hits and 10 penetrations. Damage of 4,058 hit points, all of it at close range. The one that didn't penetrate was the one that bounced off the armour of the Lurva because he hit the upper plate, not the lower plate. But when he put it into the lower plate, no problem at all. I say it's good gun, good rounds, on good penetration on those rounds. So it's not a bad tank in that respect, but it's very poor when it comes to armour. He spotted one enemy vehicle. Oh, sorry, received four hits and all four were penetrations. Yeah, the armor is dreadful on this tank. It really is paper thin. And enemy tank spotted one, five enemy vehicles damaged, two killed and 576 hit points of spotting assist. And that one, I think it's spotting assist or damage assist. He earned 66,317 credits from the game and 50,000 for completing the mission and events, so his total 116,317, and after repair, ammunition, resupply took away 86,487 credits. He received one bond for the high caliber and 1,500 XP times 4 for the first victory, 75 for this being a premium vehicle and 1,500 from personal reserves, so he took away 7,575 experience points altogether. So apart from Fluffy's not arrogant, actually it's a bit wayward behaviour. He actually did quite well. He did perform well on the standard B, and he did the right thing. After loading all four rounds into the standard B obviously fired three rounds at him because he'd already spent one of his rounds firing at his teammate. So Fluffy did take some damage, but he did the right thing. The moment he fired that last round in, he went for the ram kill and got rid of the standard B. Otherwise, he would have been a problem. But don't particularly agree with the way that he rammed Detronics running into him like that. It's not very nice to your teammate. Anyway, I think it was a good performance, and he did the right thing with the Lanson C, as I said earlier in the recommentary, because that Lanson C could have been a problem if he'd actually popped out round the corner and shot into their rears. So by dealing with that problem, forced the guy onto the outside of the building and the Borsig could deal with him from there. So nice end to that. So well done, Fluffy. Less use of premium rounds and less running into your teammates, I think. If you enjoyed that replay, please give this video a like and do subscribe to our channel. And thanks for watching.